Good afternoon.
While he sets up the PowerPoint, I want to just acknowledge a few people in the room. One is Diane Dawson, who I saw just come in. Raise your hand. Y'all know Diane, but she's like my mama. I grew up in South Carolina. I moved to Delaware in 2003. And my first day on the job, the two people I met were Buster Soares, who you guys heard earlier, and Diane Dawson. And from that day, she said to me, "I got you." Do y'all understand that language? I got you. And that was in 2003. It's now 2014, and it remains true. So I want to acknowledge and thank you, Diane, for doing that. Secondly, Brother Bilal Qayyum, if you'd raise your hand also. Brother Bilal, when I moved to Philadelphia, was also a fatherhood leader. And most of my career, all of my career, has been working with fathers. And he's been one of the guys that's been a strong pillar for me over the years. So I want to acknowledge and thank you also for being a supporter. For my few minutes today, I want to just talk about, as we talk about family values, rebuilding consensus out of confusion. I don't speak from a professional platform, but from a personal platform around the absence of fathers being critical to the foundation of our families, or the breakdown of our families. I've had the privilege of, under President Bush, operating the, at that time, which was the priority for him, was the Healthy Marriage Initiative Clearinghouse. Today, under President Obama, I have a chance, an opportunity of managing the Fatherhood Clearinghouse. And so both are two extremes. In most of my travels and conversations, the issues were the same, the absence of the father. As we've had a chance to travel to four different countries and do some of this work, the same thing resonates regardless of language, ethnicity. When dads are not home, the families are not the same. Does that make sense? So there are a couple things I want to just highlight real quickly. You'll read more about who Global Partners is, but one of our main priorities is not just as a national organization, but internationally, to be light to these families, to share with them strategies to these organizations about how they work with fathers specifically. We're everywhere on social media, so you can find us. Just Google whatever you want to do with that. I don't have a lot of time. And then one of our other elements that we want to make sure that is exposed to the country is the opportunity and ability for folks to actually write and receive federal and private dollars. I've had the great fortune with people like Bilal and Diane coaching me over the years to write about $40 million worth of grants. And so one of our newest and most proud elements that we bring to the country is the ability to train people. So if you go to our website, globalpartnersff.gov, you're gonna find a host of trainings that we're doing across the country. So with this topic, it's a great topic. Personally, from my vantage point, the starting place for me was at age 15. My father, who had been working for 15 years on a plant, decided one night to have a drink with his buddies. When he had that drink many years prior, he was an alcoholic. He took that drink and literally changed our lives. We lived in the projects. We had just moved to the suburbs. Are y'all following this? And that night changed everything for us. And so at age 15, my dad became a crack addict. And so imagine being a 15-year-old playing football and the disruption in the stands is your father. And so that was my story. And so what I promised myself, if I ever left high school, which is where I thought at the time, I'm gonna make sure that no other kid experiences that pain. And so my wife and I have been together for 17 years. Just so happens at the time that my dad left, I met this fine thing in high school that became my strength over the course of my career. And so she continues to be that. So I make the point that dads matter. I always say to her, if she ever leaves me, I'm going with her. Because she is that important to me. We have two beautiful daughters who are in the hotel as well. My commitment to them is to also that no matter what happens, I ain't going nowhere. And I'm using some plain terms, but I'm not going anywhere. And what I do know is that when dads are present and actively engaged, not only are my kids gonna be better, my wife will be better. My neighborhood is gonna be better. My church is gonna be better. The school that my kids go to is better because on a regular basis, I pick my kids up. Ain't gonna be no mess. I'm using plain terms now. But that's helpful. And so for me, when I think about this conversation, this topic, the issue around restoring the values of our families. You heard it earlier today. Some of that starts with and ends with bringing daddies back home. There's a place, there's a role for us, but I will submit to you, there are many men who have no idea when they find out that they're a father, what to do. And so for us in this body, in this assembly, with the work that you do in your communities, one of the challenges and opportunities that we have is to actually train and be a resource to help men know what to do when they find out that she is pregnant. There was a time in South Carolina where I grew up, if she happened to get pregnant, you also happened to have gotten married. That day has changed, and so we know the societal impacts of that as well. I want to just speak specifically to a couple things that support not only why this is so important, but why dads are so important. And so you can look at the research yourself. I heard a reference to the Fragile Family Study, which is foundational to this work. But what we know when dads are involved, these are a couple things that are impacted. It improves school readiness in our kids, lowers levels of disruptive behavior in our boys. I can attest to that. For the first 15 years my dad was there, my mother might have said 10 times, get dressed. My dad said, get dressed one time. Are y'all following this? And we were dressed. My mother's strong, so don't take that. But I won't even finish that sentence. It improves girls' self-esteem. There is no greater joy to me than to tell my two beautiful daughters, who are 6 and 8, I love you. There's no greater joy for me than for them to look in the mirror and know that they are beautiful. There's no greater joy for them to feel the first facial hair is mine, not some guy on the street that's trying to talk to them about something improper. When dads are involved, it improves their cognitive development. This is research of children between birth and 24 months. Some of you know the literature around dads reading to the mom, to the kids while they're in the womb. That matters. There's data that suggests that when he's actively engaged, those kids do better from birth to 24 months. When dads are actively involved, shared parenting and less stress on mothers is important. There's no greater joy for my wife than to come in the house and dinner is cooked. I know what that means to her. There's no greater joy than when I iron clothes for the week. And I'm not talking about me, I'm talking about dads. When she doesn't have to do that and do something else. And so there's a benefit to not only the kids, but to mama as well. And then last but not least, provides positive male role model for boys and girls during development. I submit to you that boys need their daddies, but so do our girls. And so at the end of the day, both of them need their dads. I'll close with just some from my 20 years of doing this work, but also my personal experience, just some key points that I think that speak to why we need and what we need to think about doing moving forward. One of those is that our children need both their mothers and their fathers. I don't doubt that. That's a fact. You can ask people here. They'll tell you the same thing. Healthy marriages and healthy relationships are not developed through osmosis. Skills need to be taught when you're young so that you can use them when you're old. I've been married 17 years. I can tell you some stories about what it is to not have an example and how it is to have something now that you can actually emulate in terms of a healthy relationship. I know several people, professionals as well, who need models. Moms and dads need the same supports and resources to be great parents. My mother, God bless her, when my wife said she was pregnant, they surrounded her with all sorts of gifts and toys. And no one came to me. And that's not an indictment on my mother. That's what happens. I needed the same instructions that when they cry for hunger, what to do with that as my wife, if I'm gonna be helpful to her. Are y'all following that? I ain't got much time now, so y'all got to agree. I'm just joking. The last two points said the earlier the dads are engaged, the better, and the longer that they're engaged. When she says she's pregnant, it's not for us to say he ain't no good. The job for us now is to surround that family with support. And then last but not least, the benefit of engaging dads in fatherhood programming or couples in healthy marriage programming is not mama or daddy, but it's the children. Thank you.